Welcome back to another episode of Tracking the Cyber Series. I'm Danger.
And I'm Kurt.
And today we're going to be pitting two copies of the Link Strike starter deck against each other. One copy apiece. So let the best opponent win. Okay, so I have my handy-dandy dice tin. It's actually a duels pack collector's tin from GX. So, let's see, die for you, die for me, high or low?
High or low. Miles.
Well, you have choice.
Alright, I think I'll start things off.
Okay. This isn't a terrible hand. Could be a lot better. Okay, so, you're up first.
I think I'm gonna start off by summoning Draconet. And use its effect to special summon a normal monster from my... it's level 2 alert. I have special summon from my hand. Pitron.
Not bad play. It's pretty decent for this deck.
Indeed it is. But I'm not done yet.
Okay.
Because now I'm going to Link Summon the Link Spider by sending Bitron to my graveyard.
Okay, that's good. That's definitely a good start.
Next, I'm going to equip Link Spider with United Beast Stand, increasing his attack points by 800 for each monster in my field.
So it's gaining 16. Not bad.
And now
that makes it a 26. Okay, I draw for my turn. I'm going to start off by setting this card here, and that card there. Then I'm going to activate the field spell card, Cyanite Universe. And it allows all my linked monsters to gain 300 attack, and once per turn I can target a monster in my grave and shuffle it into the deck. Okay. Next, since you control more monsters than I do, I'm going to special summon Evil Swarm Mandroga.
Okay.
And then I'm going to normal summon Mystery Shell Dragon. Next, I'm going to go into a... I'm going to link summon a Link 2 monster. Of Honeybot.
Interesting.
Yes. Then I'm going to activate the effect of Cyanite Universe. And target one monster in my graveyard and shuffle it into the deck. And I'm going to target Mystery Shell to shuffle it back in. Okay. Next, I'm going to enter my battle phase, and my Honeybot is attacking your Draconet. It's going to gain 300, making it a 2200. And you're going to be taking 800 points of damage. Okay, and with that, it'll be your turn.
Alright, then I draw. I think I'm going to set a monster face down in defense, but... And now, since I have, once again, I have two monsters in my field, my Link Spider goes up and attack points.
And I'm going to activate Compulsory Evacuation Device to return your Link Spider to your hand. Hence, sending it back to the extra deck.
And so it seems you got to my monster.
Yeah, slightly.
It's only temporary, though. I end my turn.
I draw. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Next, I'm going to activate Monster Reincarnation and discard my Fiendish Chain that I drew for my turn to add Evil Swarm Mandroga back to my hand. Next, I'm going to normal summon my Evil Swarm Mandroga to the field, and then I'm going to enter my battle phase. My 1550 Mandroga is declaring an attack on your set card.
Much that card happens to be Raikou, Roulette's 100.
Okay.
Raikou's effect activates when it's flipped. I can target one card on and then field and destroy it. So I choose to destroy Honeybot.
Ah.
And since it flipped, I also have to mill the top three cards of my deck.
So you're losing a Fiendish Chain, a Book of Moon,
and a Ram Cloud.
Well, that's interesting.
So yeah, because I've been happy to get those cards in my hand, but sometimes you win some, you lose some.
Yeah. Okay. And I think it's going to be your turn now.
I draw for my turn. I summon Beast King Barbaros.
Well, a 1900. And I think I'm going to hit with Bottomless Trap Hole to destroy it and then banish it.
I'm not going to do that, dude.
No, that should work.
That's
fine. Try to fix things a little.
Well then, since I no longer have my monster, I'll place one more card face down in my field and end my turn.
Cool. I draw. Well, that's not good. My Evil Swarm Mandroga is declaring a direct attack for 1550.
I'm gonna Mirror Force it, just because.
Okay. And that leaves me with an empty field, and you with an empty field. Your turn.
Well, then I draw. I guess right now it leaves us with both an empty field. My turn.
I draw. And I'm going to set one monster, and end my turn.
Well, then I draw. And this time, I special summon Photon Thrasher.
Ah, interesting. 2100.
Since you control Monster Knight, don't I special summon? And since he's the only monster on my field, he can attack. So that's exactly what it's going to do. Attack the set monster.
You attacked my set Bitron. It has 2000 defense.
My
and it dies.
2100 attack points.
My turn?
It's your turn.
I draw. And I'm going to activate the effect of Sign It Universe, returning my Honeybot back into my extra deck.
Interesting plan.
Yeah, so I can use it again later. And next, I'm going to activate the spell card, Dark Hole, to destroy all your monsters. Too bad there's only one. Next, I'm going to Normal Summon my Photon Thrasher.
Cannot be Normal Summoned.
Oh, well, Special Summoned. Thank you.
Because
I control no monsters.
Yep.
So now my Photon Thrasher is going to attack you for 2100.
I looks like I'll be taking that 21.
Okay. My pen is dying. And that's going to put you at 51.
Not bad.
Yes. It's your move now. I have no cards in my hand.
No cards in hand? And now, no cards on field. First, I'm going to activate Mystical Space Typhoon to destroy Silent Universe.
Okay, when it's destroyed, it sends all monsters in the extra monster zones to the graveyard. Too bad there isn't any of yours.
Next, I'm going to play a spell card, Dark Hole, getting rid of Photon Thrasher.
Well, this is very one-sided.
Next, I'm also going to Normal Summon Galaxy Serpent.
And I'm going to take some damage, I'm guessing.
Well, of course, you're bound to take some damage.
Okay, and I take 1,000 damage then.
Galaxy Serpent will attack you for 1,000 points of damage. And
that'll put me at 7,000 to your 51.
And for now, it looks like I'll just have to end my turn.
I draw.
Let's see what else I can get.
And I'm going to set one monster and end my turn.
I draw.
So, what you doing this turn?
Actually, this time, I believe I'm going to have my Galaxy Serpent go to defense mode and my turn.
Oh, okay. I draw a card. And I think that... I think I'm just going to end my turn.
I'm going to activate my Sign It Universe.
Interesting.
Then I'm going to use Sign It Universe as an effect in order to return one of my monsters in my graveyard back to the deck. I think I'm going to choose.
Okay. Add a normal monster back in.
I
my draw card. Now I'm going to normal summon card D in attack mode.
Interesting.
Then I'm going to activate its effect. I'm going to send it to the graveyard to draw two cards. And then my turn.
Once more. This time I'm going to add back of the lights from Hunter back to my deck.
Okay.
And I'm going to send Galaxy Serpent Rider, right home to the Insomniac Spider.
Okay, I'm going to summon.
And so, and thanks to Static Universe, I have 300 attack points for the creature, probably the
That's fun.
So, Link Spider will attack your set box.
And you attacked into a Ryko, like one Hunter?
Okay. So, it's going to.
It's going to destroy your Static Universe.
It's also destroyed Link Spider.
Yes. And then I'm going to be sending a Draco Net, United We Stand, and Mystery Shell Dragon to the graveyard. And then Ryko dies.
Yep. Well, I need to survive.
I draw. And I'm going to set two cards in my Spell Trap card zones, and end my turn.
Well, I draw. My turn.
I draw for my turn. I'm going to special summon Link Slayer because I control no monsters. And it is a 2000, level 5. Yes. So now my Link Slayer is going to attack directly for 2000. Okay, well, your turn then. That doesn't work. I draw. I think I'm going to summon out Furry Bandit. Attack me. And then I'm going to Furry Bandit attack with 1,000 points of attack against your Battle Fader.
That's fine by me.
It's vanished. And then my Link Slayer is going to attack for 2,000.
I'm going to activate Ring of Destruction and target your Link Slayers
on. Okay, so then you're going to take the damage.
And then
how exactly does this work right now? During your opponent's turn, target one face-up monster your opponent controls whose attack is less than or equal to their life points. Destroy that face-up monster, and if you do, take damage equal to its original attack. Then inflict damage to your opponent equal to the damage you took. You only activate one Ring of Destruction per turn. So Link Slayer dies, you take the damage.
And then you take the damage.
Yes.
I take 2, then you take 2.
That'll put you at 1. I take 2. That'll put me at 5,000. So you have 31, I have 5,000.
Alright, just fall out from me.
Yep. Now it's your turn.
Alright. Then I will draw. I'm going to set 1 card face down and expect some Cyber Dragon in my field.
Interesting. I think I'm going to activate my Ring of Destruction now.
Well, then I will activate Compulsory Evacuation Device, returning Cyber Dragon to my hand.
Interesting change. So, Compulse returns your Cyber Dragon before Ring of Destruction can destroy it. A good play. Because it's still your main phase.
And since it's still my turn, and obviously you have a monster, I can bring back to the field Cyber Dragon once more.
Hmm. Nice protection scheme.
Indeed. Now Cyber Dragon will lay waste to your Furry Bandit.
Except
attack!
It won't. Because I'm going to hit it with Mirror Force. My turn?
Yes, your turn.
I draw. I set a card. And I'm going to tribute to my Curry Bandit for my Cyber Dragon.
And I'm going to activate Torrential Tribute.
I'm going to end my turn.
well. I end my turn.
I draw. I'm going to set this card here, and end my turn.
I draw. I'm going to set this monster, and end my turn.
During your end phase, I'm going to activate the trap card Hole of the Haunted to bring back to my fields.
One of your best bet right now is...
Cyber Dragon, yeah. Okay. I draw for my turn now. And I'm going to normal summon Galaxy Serpent. Then I'm going to link summon my Link Spider with my Galaxy Serpent. My Link Spider is going to declare an attack.
Okay. You are attacking a marshmallow, so you will take 1,000 points of damage.
Data card attack. Fine. That'll put me at 4,000. So you're 31. Well then, I think I'm going to, during my main phase 2, Link Summon with my Link Spider and Cyber Dragon to summon out Eco Talker.
Interesting.
Yes. It's now your turn.
Alright. I draw for my turn. I think I'm going to... Okay, Burden of Might.
Well, that's nice.
For fun. If you have anything else planned for me, I'll set one card face down. That'll be all.
I draw for my turn. I'm going to set this card here, and end my turn.
Alright, for my next move, I shuffle this one more card face down, and end my turn.
Okay, I draw a card, I set a card in my spell and trap card zones, and end my turn. We're at a little bit of a stalemate right now. So I can get around that marshmallow.
Looks like I end my turn.
I draw, and I'm going to set another card in my spell and trap card zone and end my turn.
This is turning out to be a really fun spell and trap card set barrage. I end my turn.
I draw. Interesting. I'm going to normal summon Ram Clouder.
Okay.
And I'm going to tribute my set monster, especially summon one Cyberse monster from my graveyard, and I'm going to choose Link Slayer.
Ooh.
Yes. So now my Decode Talker's all linked up. And it gains 500 attack for each one that it points to.
Yeah, so it's over 1,000. That's...
Yeah.
Sounds pleasant for you.
Next, I'm going to have to end my turn. I still don't have a way around that marshmallow.
Well, there's definitely a way. I just haven't figured it out yet.
Reincarnation is clear.
Alright, I'm gonna send Terraform. I'm going to add Raven Head.
Okay.
Next, I'm going to send my Draken Head. I'm going to send Draken Head using its effect. I'm going to choose for somebody level 2 from my deck. So I'm going to send my field Bitron.
Ah. Going for your own Decode Talker, then?
Indeed I am. So now, with mine and all in nice, ready positions, I believe it's time I go for my Decode Talker.
Well, I'm going to set your Draconet before you can Link Summon.
Interesting.
here, and that is there. That'll effectively stop you for one turn. And that's all I need. Summon Exoron Universe underneath my Decode Talker. And I'm going to enter my battle phase. My Decode Talker is going to attack and destroy Pitron with its 3,300 attack points.
Not much I can really do about that. That's true.
And my Link Slayer with its 2,000 attack points is attacking your set Draconet.
Well, it's not 2,000, but it's only 15, but it's still bigger than my Draconet normally. But I'm going to Forbidden Lance it and drop it down by 800 points.
You're targeting...
I target your...
Link Slayer, huh?
Link Slayer in order to decrease his attack points by 800. Although he might...
And I'm going to activate my Dark Bribe card.
So I get to draw a card, but in your respect, I don't need to use my Forbidden Lance.
Yes. So then Link Slayer kills your Draconet, effectively stopping you from getting your Decode Talker. And now I'm going to have to end my turn.
Nice roll. You thought you stopped my Decode Talker from hitting the field, and I didn't remember speaking. Just a little off. I summon Marauding Captain, which would then allow a special summon, Exarian Universe.
Well, I'm going to activate Torrential Tributes.
So now you're getting rid of everything.
Yes. Do you have any responses to that?
No. Not one.
Okay. Sadly, I lose my Decode Talker, but I cleared your entire field off.
Temporary.
Okay.
It seems to be your turn.
I draw. Well then. Now it's your turn.
Interesting. I summon Evil Swarm Mandragora.
Okay.
Now my Evil Swarm Mandragora will attack you directly.
I'm going to discard my Swift Scarecrow to the graveyard to negate the attack and end the battle phase.
I end my turn.
I draw, and I'm going to activate Terraforming.
No field spells, right?
Nope, we don't have any other field spells.
I kind of figured this was my used my...
Oh, in order for proof.
Yeah.
Because after proof, I do not have one. That's actually a tournament rule right there, proving to your opponent you do not contain the card in your deck. So for all of you watching out there that are just getting into the game, okay, and that's my turn.
Alrighty then. Well, I shall draw a card. I wish I had this card sooner. Supply Squad.
Nice.
Now it was one Mandragora. Attack him directly.
So I'm going to take 1550?
Yep.
I'll put me at 2450. I draw for my turn. I got Supply Squad myself.
Interesting.
It's your move.
Set one card face down, and you just want to draw while attacking the record.
So another 1550. That'll put me at 900? Okay.
Yep.
Yeah. Okay, this is close. If I don't get a monster on my field, I lose.
Well,
I draw for my turn. And I have to end my turn.
Okay.
Yep.
Well, I draw. I'm going to summon the field Curry Bandit.
Okay. Curry Bandit, huh?
Yep. And now Curry Bandit's going to attack you directly for me.
No, it's not, because I'm gonna activate Battle Fader. Which is going to negate your attack and end the battle phase.
I see. So anyway, you didn't have to do that, did you?
Barely. So, is it my move
during the end phase of the turn, I'm gonna add the current bandit's ability by distributing it all. I can reroll the top 5 and add any one spell or trap for my of those to my hand. But the rest is getting my graveyard.
Well, it looks like you're getting the Pot of Duality and that's it. Because doesn't it say spell card?
Spell or
trap. Okay, so you have two choices.
I'm grabbing a Claw of the Honey card. The rest are going to my graveyard. But that's no worry. Because once they do, I'm actually Jar of Angers.
Ah. So you have me in grind game now. Mm-hmm. Nice.
Now I can put exactly whatever cards I want back into the deck. Well, 5 of them.
You're playing hard to get with this.
Well, I'm not going to allow this to be an easy win for you, now am I?
Well, this is a very hard game to go with, to start with here, so... That's 2.
I think I'm going to take Marauding Captain, Draconet, and Patron.
So... 5 cards, huh? Actually, that goes on top, remember?
Oh, yeah.
Let's follow the rules.
Those are the 5 that take back into the deck.
Okay. Your very small deck.
As it was all worth it.
Yes, I thought I would be able to stall you. Because I forced you to draw another card.
That forced you to draw me another card is what screwed you over.
Is it?
No. Actually, technically you'd still have a little bit more life points, but there's enough. Because that was would've been one more turn before I would draw that.
Yeah.
It would've saved you a little life. It's not a lot.
By one turn.
Hey, but since that was my end phase, it is now your turn.
I draw. Nice. Let's see. Okay, I can work with that. I'm going to normal Sub-Beast King Barbarossa with its effect. But then it's losing 800. But that's not why it's here. Because I'm going to link summon for my last link monster, Honeybot. Which is a 1900.
And no levels, so Burden does not threaten you.
Yes. Now my 1900 is going to attack your 1550.
And I'll take 450 points of damage, but thanks to the supply spot, I get the draw card. So. That's the last one point left for you after all.
That'll put you at 26 points.
I will.
We've both got faster.
Well, you also get other monsters, so... I think I'll suppose I'll have a special skill for Cyberse, since you can go faster than I
can. Oh, how many times? Cyberse on the field right now.
Oh, how great that would be for me.
Yes, it would be the same time.
Yes,
no, actually, I'd be 2200.
I'll set one of the cards down and seven down and we'll attack your honey bomb.
Okay.
Don't forget you have
to. I want to. 7.
Well, if you're going to
7. My 700, you're 2650. And I think I will. Yep, my turn. I draw. I'm going to set this card and set this monster. I'm going to activate Jar of Avarice now.
I'm going to activate the Dark Prime Trick card. I get to draw it. Well, now I'm going to do it. I'm going to draw it back.
Trying to extend the game a little. I'm going to stop your Moronic Captain with my effect banner by discarding it to the graveyard. Nope, no Tico for you.
No, it's fine. Call the Hunt.
He gets Tico anyways. I was trying to stop Tico, but Tico
died. I don't know, but that's so bad. And now I'm gonna use all three of my monsters to glitch some decode topic.
Hull stays. That's why mine is still here.
It's like sandbag. It's like how it was served before. The monster dressed for 1500.
Yes.
That's the 1500 back. So now I get my search. So I choose to add my Break on it.
Too bad you've already normal summoned this turn.
Yes, yes. But I have a feeling you'll save mine. Decode will attack your monster.
It's Angie.
Yeah, what do you know? Same energy.
Hey, there's actually a legal target left in here.
That's a bad thing if you have. It really is bad that you have to take
that. Cut that?
No. There's no to pick it up.
If it was any order I want, I'd put Call of the Haunted back in there.
Summon
out my decode. My turn. I draw a card. I'm going to set this card. Then I'm going to activate Mystical Space Typhoon to destroy your Burden of the Mighty. And then I'm going to normal summon Rotting Captain.
Ready, you're just ready to end yourself.
It's your move.
Okay, I draw. You really are about to end yourself. This is going to get a lot worse. I'm going to summon Draconet and use its effect to summon the one. My three-part four is three-part deck now.
That's it.
I'm going to equip Minerva Stand to Deco Talk.
Ouch!
And I'm going to see Forbidden Lands to Deco Talk.
Okay. That hurts. Okay, that's a little bit.
I'm going to take 800 of that back out.
You're taking a lot more than 800 of it out. Because if you didn't
it's
unaffected by the effects of spell. And it's still a good thing, but it's unaffected by it.
Yep. So it's dropping 800 out of the 23. Is it enough to kill me?
That would make it 15 plus the 500 for each one points. It would be 3,000. That would kill you? 30,000.
Dropping it. Forbidden Lands.
There's 0.3 of them. It's plus 15.
Oh.
And the minus.
Okay.
The minus is.
Good game.
The minus is. Puts it down to 15.
That was fun.
Otherwise, it would have been plus 8. Plus 24, so plus 32 on top of 3, but even 62.
Ouch!
That is by far the probably most powerful matchup you can possibly
do. Well, that will show you right there just about everything that's in both packs. So I hope you enjoyed watching this episode of the Tracking the Cyberse series, where we pit two Night Strike starter decks against each other.
It turned out to be very, very fun.
Yes, very long, but very fun. It went so long, our camera actually ran out of space, so we have to switch to our backup camera. So, the final 15 minutes or so of this video, I'm sorry if there was a quality dip in there. Our backup camera is actually an older model from a couple of years ago. But I hope you guys enjoyed watching this and found it informative on some of the combos that can come up in the deck. I'm Danger.
And I'm Kurt.
And this has been another episode of the Tracking the Cyberse series on the Danger Yu-Gi-Oh! Channel. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe. And this is the Danger Yu-Gi-Oh! Channel, signing off.